I like to think of the Earth as a single complex system, with Antarctica its heart. The slowly beating pump that drives the entire planet. Antarctica affects all of our lives through forces so deep and elemental, we're not even aware of them. While most see the seventh continent as an impenetrable icy fortress, far beyond the influence of man, parts of Antarctica are increasingly impacted by outside forces, and thus at great risk. Today, Antarctica is changing, and changing fast. My introduction to Antarctica in 1989 was also my first assignment for National Geographic, documenting a 7-month-long crossing of the continent by dog sled. Since then, I've been back many times to both its high, cold interior and along the wondrous coast of its 600-mile-long peninsula, bearing witness to the changes impacting this fast-evolving corner of our planet. One thing I've learned is once you've been to Antarctica, the place stays in your blood forever. Wanting to go to Antarctica and actually getting there are two very different things. For us, that meant hiring a sailboat to get us there. Skip Novak has been sailing his boats, the Pelagic and Pelagic Australis, to the peninsula for 20 years. He and I had been talking for many years about the logistics of my expedition. Since 1959, a one-of-a-kind international treaty has governed the continent. One thing the treaty demands is assurance that you won't leave anything behind other than footprints on what is still the most pristine place on the planet. It also requires that you provide your own search and rescue. There is no Navy or Coast Guard, no 911 to call in case you get in trouble in Antarctica.